tell you, Sister Richie. I believe that trumpet can sound any day.
All right.
I've got lost loved ones. Amen. I've got children that's lost.
Yeah.
Without God. Yeah. But I know what His promises are to me.
Yeah.
And I know if I can live up to my end of it,
come on.
He'll do His end.
That's right.
He'll do His end. They won't have no choice but come in if I live up to my end.
Come on.
If I do what I'm supposed to do, God will make them so miserable that somewhere or another they'll have to cry out to Him.
That's right.
Amen.
Preach.
But that's what we got to do. We got to become His Word. We got to live His Word. And this has got to be our foundation.
Say it.
Too many people are building their foundation on everything in the world.
Yes, sir.
They're building no business.
Yeah.
Money.
Right.
New cars. Want everything, but they ain't building nothing on Jesus.
Come on.
Yeah.
Everything else is going to burn up over these days, church.
All right.
But this will stand. This will get us through.
Yes,
you
sir.
Can't make it up there in a new automobile.
That's right.
You can't make it up there in a new home.
Come on.
But you can make it up there in this.
Amen.
You can make it with Jesus. If we'll hang on to
it
and put it all in His hand. Amen.
Yeah.
See, God still hates sin.
That's right.
He hates sin.
That's it.
And sooner or later, if you keep allowing, if churches keep allowing sin come in their church, sooner or later God will depart.
That's it.
Amen.
He won't stand, Sister Rich. Sooner or later, he'll write you goodbye over the door.
Amen.
Glory to God is departed.
That's right.
Amen. It's time that the churches get real. Amen.
Come on.
There's too many fake churches.
Yes, sir.
Too many fake preachers. That's not called a bit more than nothing. Too many people just, all they are is a show. Entertainers.
Come on.
You can fill this church up with an entertaining preacher.
Yeah.
You put Jesse the blandest behind his pulpit, you won't be able to get him through that door.
Yeah.
Come on.
But you put somebody back there or preach on sin and you can't get nobody to come in, hardly.
That's it.
Amen.
Amen.
True. But the one that's preaching on sin and preaching the truth.
Amen.
That's the one's going to lead them somewhere.
Yes, sir.
That's the one's going to get them somewhere. Amen.
That's it.
But we got to stand on His word, Brother Billy.
Yes, sir.
If I ain't going to preach this, I ain't going to preach.
Come on.
Amen.
I'll quit preaching.
Yeah.
If I can't preach, it's God. It's just God's word. Amen.
Yeah.
But this is only, He's the only one who knows what you need.
That's it.
He's the only one who knows what I need. Amen.
That's it.
He knew what I had need of, Sister Ethan. And He met my need.
Amen.
He knew what Sister Merle got need of, and He met her need.
Come on.
Amen. He'll meet our need, church.
Yes, sir.
When there seems to be no way,
yeah.
If we're trusting and depend on Him.
Amen.
Amen. But sometimes this old flesh gets up and we mess up.
Yes.
Yeah.
But we got to have to serve with the Father.
That's right.
When we mess up, Brother Billy, all we got to do is come to an old altar and say, Lord, forgive me. He's right there next. I mess up every now and then.
Come on.
I messed up big time the other day. I don't know why I'm going to tell this, but I'm going to tell it on myself anyway. I was getting ready to preach at Joel City Church. I was trying to get ready. I was studying His Word. And my wife, bless her heart, she said, run down to the dollar store and get me something. And I don't know why, but it flew all over me. Because I just opened my Bible. And just getting ready to study.
Yeah.
I said, okay, and I shut my Bible and I took on and went down to the dollar store. Got down there and got what she wanted and started out the door. And this woman come out the door. And she run over me. Knocked that bag, knocked that stuff all over that parking lot.
Uh-oh.
And I screamed, you idiot.
Uh-oh.
All right. And I turned around and looked, and she was chasing a little bit of child that run out the door into the parking lot. And I started to walk off, Brother Billy. Got all the way over to the truck. God said, you need to apologize.
Yeah, yeah.
I said, Lord, she's the one run over me. He said, you need to apologize for that. I had to go back in that dollar store and tell that lady I was sorry for calling her idiot.
Yeah.
She said, well, I was thinking to come apologize to you, but I couldn't get away from this kid. See, church?
That's it.
People's eyes are on you, too.
Amen.
We all mess up.
Amen.
We all make mistakes.
That's
amen.
Right.
Amen. What if somebody said, you know, somebody, next person she run into, well, you know what, old preacher Bill Willis?
Yeah.
He called me an idiot.
Yeah.
Run right on off. I wouldn't go here and preach for nothing.
That's yeah. It.
See?
Amen.
That's right.
We got to watch what we're doing.
Amen.
We got to be light. Amen. We all still mess up.
That's right.
There's not a one of us in here that don't mess up every
amen.
Now and
then.
I don't think.
That's
if
right.
You are, look out the whirlwind. I'll take you out of here.
That's right.
And I praise God.
Amen.
That when I mess up, Brother Billy, He don't let me go on.
Oh, amen. Hallelujah.
That He's put something down inside of me to disturb me, that I can still feel a conviction that you need to make that right.
Come on.
Amen.
Because I want to make it. And I don't want nothing in there, Brother David, to keep me from making it. Amen. And I want to be a witness. And I want to be a light. And I don't want nothing to keep me from being that light for Jesus. Amen. And I'm thankful that he's still got something inside of me, that he's still stirring my heart. Amen. And when it lets me know when I mess up. Amen. That he still puts conviction on people. Amen. A lot of churches ain't got no conviction in them anymore because they think it's all right. Because they don't think they're doing nothing wrong. Amen. Because the preacher done told me it was all right. But honey, if I get in his word and get in it, you'll get some conviction. Amen. If somebody will preach your truth, amen, they'll step on your toes every now and then. Amen. A lot of people say, I don't want to hear that preacher. He'll get on my toes. If he's getting on your toes, he's doing you some good. Amen. Oh. If he's cutting you a little bit, it says it's sharp as a two-edged sword. Every now and then, it's got to cut you. It's got to slice you. It's got to get you to line up. It's got to prune you a little bit.
Come on.
Amen. I still need pruning, brother. I ain't made it yet. Amen. So, well, you're a preacher. That ain't got nothing to do with it. Preachers mess up every day. The devil fights just too. Amen. It's just as hard as not hard. He's going to fight.
That's right.
And I'm thankful that I still got that conviction inside me, amen. Yes. Every now and then.
Come on.
Not every now and a whole lot. When I mess up.
Yeah.
He lets me know.
Come on.
You need to make it right.
Amen.
Not only to them.
Yeah.
But you better make it right to God.
Amen.
You better get it right with him.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm thankful for his word. And I'm thankful for his truth.
Exactly.
And Brother David, I know with all my heart, if I stand upon his word and I trust him.
That's right.
And I follow what he tells me to do, I'll make it. I can't miss it.
Come on.
I can't miss it because he won't let me.
That's it.
I trust him. But we got to trust him. Give the Lord a hand for his word. Amen.
Amen.
Thanks, Lord. Come on, brother.